All right, we're joined with Hobart Hockey head coach Mark Taylor, first-year Bauer Morrissey, and senior captain Artem Buzoverya, following a 4-3 win in the fourth overtime over Curry in the quarterfinals of the NCAA tournament. Coach, you want to just start us off with your thoughts on the game?
I mean, it's a great hockey game. I mean, for me, you know, certainly after the win, and I thought about it before we did win, I was like, this is an awesome. If we come up with a win, this will be great for the fans. Our students were gone, which is too bad. Most of them are gone. Some were still here, but having the Geneva faithful here with us, it was awesome that they got to see the W. And I'm pumped. I mean, I really wanted this win for this group. These guys have done a lot this year. It's a special group of guys, and I couldn't be happier that it came out for them. That they took the page out of the book from last year of perseverance, and we stayed in there to an outstanding Curry team, well coached, well played. I mean, hats off to them. You know, I was also going through my mind, this one could go either way. Thankfully, it went our way.
What's it like to play it? Well, for you to coach, but to play a game like this?
I didn't play, I coached, you know, quite honestly. Been in a lot of hockey games. To me, it was, you know, you just want the guys to stay the course in what they've been doing all year. And, you know, if they give me full effort and they do things together with their best focus and best attitude, I'm not sweating on the bench, you know, even if it's we don't come out with the win. The guys gave everything they had. They did it together, and to me, that's what I asked for. And fortunately, it worked out for us.
Bauer, I happened to be standing next to the referee observer, and a few minutes before you scored, he made a comment, that number four looks like the most active one right now on the ice. Did you feel that, and why was that?
I did. Thankfully, we play 7D, so by the fourth overtime, I still felt all right, and with Moose going down, I knew all six, the rest of us had to step up and, you know, make some plays, and as we all know, our D-core is very, very good, and I'm just happy we got the job done.
And you want to talk about the striker goal?
Well, yeah, it starts with the face-off win. And I don't know, I kind of just blacked out, but I knew I could bait one of them. We had a good screen in front, and I just hoped for the best.
Bauer and Artie and anybody on the bench, really, when you guys are in the second, third, fourth overtimes and you're just trying to find a way past this freshman goalie that Curry's got, I mean, are you shooting really anything anywhere, or are you still looking for alleyways and maybe weaknesses up high, down low, or are you just kind of throwing it at the net?
You got it.
I believe our team was really composed all throughout overtime. We still look for plays. We came so close so many times, and one of them was bound to go in. We just kept going, kept pushing. Their guys had no legs whatsoever, and our team stepped up and did the best we could.
Yeah, I think shout out to Joeler. I think he did a good job pre-scouting the goalie, told us that we should probably shoot low blocker. I don't think we did a lot of that today. We scored glove for his goal. But, yeah, I mean, in OT, you just kind of put everything towards the net and hope it goes in, and especially in those games where it's four OTs, exhausted. I think he had like 92 saves or something like that, 91. That's pretty ridiculous for a goalie. So I think he was exhausted back there. So just put everything on net and hope one of them goes in. And then lucky for us, this guy had an eye for it today.
This goes out to all of you guys. Yesterday, when you guys were up 2-0 or down 2-0, had that one cooking for a while. You know, what's going on the bench and in between periods? I mean, how are you guys getting the morale back up there? Was it a little shocking that you guys were down 2-0 all of a sudden when you were putting all these shots on net? What was going on the bench and in the locker room when you guys had to fight back there?
I mean, that's hockey. Like, sometimes it doesn't go your way, and you just have to battle. Like Coach said, it's all about perseverance. In between the periods, we just stuck to our game plan, so that we just have to keep doing what we've been doing all year, which has been pretty successful for us. So that's kind of the message, and obviously Coach reinforced it, but just keep talking through it, just going after it every single shift. And then obviously Tanner put a good first in, and then Dukes in the third and beginning of third gave us a little bit of life, and then obviously Jonah. So overall, it just hard times are going to come, especially in this game. You won't get every single bounce like last year. I think we got a lot of those bounces, and it was time for us to get tested, and I think it'll serve us really well going forward playing Utica next week and then whoever makes it to the final.
The best thing about this group is our resilience, and our leaders do such a good job of leading the way. I mean, Artem's dancing in the between the third and fourth overtime, yelling, screaming, getting us going. So we knew we had the game. It's just a matter of who was going to score.
And I felt good as the game went on. I thought they did it at Geneseo. They did it with us. They had a couple good chances, and they capitalized on them versus the number that we had. And, you know, one beautiful shot from 14. He's a heck of a player for him inside. And but as it went on, I kept looking at Beavs and, you know, between the periods, and he's like, he's not sweating like that. And I think as the game went on, I thought he – you know, he made a couple of huge saves for us, you know, the glove save and stuff like that. I thought he was sharper, as sharp at the end of the game as he was at the beginning. I don't fault him. He's probably going to be thinking, you know, three goals against. But, you know, they were a good, you know, two of them were real good three goals. And the other one was like one we got. Crash the net and kick it around and beat it up and pound it in. So those you don't fault your goalie on. And I had a real good confidence, and I said it to those guys. Look at Beavs; he's ready for like three more games, you know. And he was. It was the last time we went out. I think I made that comment, and he's sitting out the other end, cool, calm, and as collected as ever. And so, heck of a duel between goaltenders. Heck of a duel between two teams that gave it their all out there, and good for hockey.
Good start. An even better second and a real good third or something along those lines.
Yes, so, yeah.
Does that run out the door when you hit third overtime? I mean, you run out of mottos? What are you saying?
Actually, our motto was just, hey, keep doing what we're doing. Joel Storm came in, it might have been the last one or the next one, and he just said, I'm trying to remember what he said because that was yesterday. But what did you say, Joel?
I think it was just like we're –
keep doing what we're still where we want to be, and keep doing what we're doing. And that was before the last overtime, and I think that's what we did, and that's how we came out. So it's good having young bucks like Joel around to give me good information.
Coach, you guys set the NCAA record for longest home winning streak. What is it about this building that you guys just love playing in?
I think it's like when you make something your home. You know, is your home is where you're at. You put your hat, and that goes back to generations before this group for sure. I mean, the alums have made the cooler a special place, even when it didn't have walls on it. And so, it's you know, it's worked out really well for us that way.
Two questions real quickly. Yeah. One, how do you physically get your team prepared? Short week, and two,
okay, yeah, I didn't know who won what game, so basically we'll get back to doing what we need to do, and we didn't play last weekend, we played two this weekend, so as far as I'm concerned, we're even. So we played two games over 2 weeks, so don't cry on my shoulder, get back to work.
What about Utica?
I don't know enough about them yet. I mean, they're good at this point, everybody's a good hockey team. I just don't know enough about him right now. I mean, I didn't spend any time watching really anybody until I have to watch him.
All right, thank you.